Do you guys remember what I said back in October? It's finally happening. Jamal Adams is asking for a trade. J-E-T-S, Jets, Jets, Jets! Welcome to Jets Talk. My name's Ryan. I'll be your pilot today. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button. If you've been here before, welcome back. I love having you here. I apologize for the lack of videos. I've been busy with work the last few weeks, so I've only been doing the live streams, but this is the first video that I'm making for you guys in probably about 2 weeks now. It's not a video that I'm happy about making, but it's one that I can kind of say, I told you so. Back in October, I said Jamal Adams was upset that he was not traded to Dallas, and it appears that I'm probably right. Or at least, it doesn't appear like Jamal actually wants to be here. And I caught a lot of hate for that that comment, the video that I made, the few videos that I made over the course of the offseason saying that this was eventually going to be what happens. As it's being reported, Jamal Adams has asked and requested a trade from the New York Jets to basically anywhere else. It's not surprising for me that Jamal wants to be traded. I said over the course of the offseason, the last two drafts that we've had, Jamal Adams came out and was over the top excited for all the draft picks, and he tweets out each one individually. This past year, you didn't see that. You saw one bulk lump, tweet out that said, oh, can't wait to have you on the Jets, or whatever it exactly said. But the other tweets you did see this offseason, you saw a lot of excitement for when Christian McCaffrey got his deal. You saw a lot of excitement when Laremy Tunsil got his deal. The comments we saw recently with the Myles Garrett contract potentially stirring up a bit more controversy with Jamal Adams. So obviously, Jamal Adams is all about his money, which I don't really have a problem with. He's outplayed his contract. I understand that. And I have no problems with wanting to pay him the highest paid safety contract in the league. I just don't want to do it this year. And the Jets don't want to do it this year. Or at least it doesn't seem like the Jets want to do it this year. And there's a lot of reasons why. The Jets have him under contract for 2 years, not to mention the two franchise tags that you could feasibly use. On top of that, you don't know what the 2020 cap situation is going to look like because of what happens with fans in the stands. Could that salary cap go down because the salary cap is based on the revenue brought in by the league? So the Jets are holding all the cards in this situation. Now, Jamal could hold out. Sure, that's a possibility, but the CBA makes it so hard that he'll actually lose an accrued season towards free agency. So it's not really going to benefit Jamal at all in this situation. What really gets me, and I don't care so much about the trade, it's this next little bit. There is a select few teams that Jamal Adams would be willing to play for without reaching a new deal on a contract, which tells me he never wanted to be in New York to begin with. If you are willing to go to another franchise and not get paid, why couldn't you do that here? Why couldn't you play for our New York Jets, the team that drafted you? We put all our stock into you. And you're demanding all this money, but are willing to go to another team and play with the same contract. I said it was going to happen. I told you guys, he's going to drag us through the dirt. And I was hoping it wouldn't happen. And you're seeing it now. Now, if I'm Joe Douglas, what do I do? Like I said, the Jets hold all the cards here. I would not trade Jamal Adams for anything short of what I want for Jamal. Last year, that was reported to be a first and 2 seconds, or, you know, a really high caliber player and a first. That's going to be the asking price for Jamal, because guess what? I can keep Jamal on my team. I don't have to trade him. Now, I do think we should move him, because I think the type of personality that he is turning into right now is toxic for a locker room and is not good. Let's kind of talk about where he could potentially go. The seven teams that he's listed off that he would be willing to go to and not sign an immediate long-term deal: the Ravens, the Cowboys, the Texans, the Chiefs, the Eagles, the 49ers, and the Seahawks. When I immediately look at this list, I see the Ravens and the Eagles as the two ties to Joe Douglas and potentially maybe a little bit more of an open door with trade negotiations. The Ravens, they have Matthew Judon, their edge rusher, on a franchise tag, so that would be the obvious swap for me, him for Jamal. I would probably want picks in return as well, or at least one kind of higher pick, just because Jamal is on a cheaper deal for the next few years. When you're drafting or taking someone on with a franchise tag, you're paying that person the average of the top five of their position, so you're not really getting any leverage there. The Eagles, this one doesn't make sense to me because they're going to be $50 million over the salary cap in 2021, So even if they were to bring in Jamal, I don't know how they're really going to be able to extend him beyond next year anyway, or beyond this season regardless. So I don't really see the Eagles as much of an option. I don't even have like a player on the Eagles that I want if I'm the New York Jets. You'd have to pay me a ton of money in draft picks for that to work. The Cowboys and Texans, those are both obviously Texas teams. Jamal is from Texas. He was a Cowboys fan growing up. There's been a lot of smoke around the whole Cowboys and what they could potentially offer for Jamal Adams. CeeDee Lamb has been thrown into the discussion for a lot of Jet fans. I wanted CeeDee Lamb really bad, so him with a few draft picks is certainly not a bad thing in my book. But Jamal Adams to the Cowboys, I would like to not trade him there because I know that's where he really wants to go. The Texans, Bill O'Brien has a history now of awful trades. That would be my preference on where I would probably want to send him because we'd probably get the most back in return. In terms of the Chiefs, 49ers, and Seahawks, I'd have to look and see what players they actually have potentially on the block that we could, in theory, take on. None are really ringing a bell off the top of my head right now. But if I were Joe Douglas, I'm super spiteful. This is really not okay if you're trying to run a team. But I would not want to give Jamal what he wants. I would trade him away to wherever we'll take him, like Detroit or the Jaguars, somewhere like that where he doesn't really want to play, but he'll kind of have to go and play because they could hold his rights for 4 years. Now, personally me, I would love to trade him for Yannick Ngakoue, the fabulous pass rusher from the Jacksonville Jaguars. I would consider trading him straight up because I think Ngakoue is that good of a player at 25 years old. He's going to be an elite edge rusher in this league. But realistically, with Jamal, with 2 years left on his rookie deal and franchise tags after that, you can definitely get draft compensation in addition to Ngakoue if you could possibly swing that. Now, guys, let me know what you think down below in the comments. What do you want for Jamal Adams? How do you feel about this whole situation? Are you as jazzed up as I am? Let me know in the comments down below. And as always, go Jets.